Hi, my name is Luciana, and in this demo, I'm going to talk a little bit about developing Django applications in Dev containers. We're going to use Visual Studio Code and three extensions, the Python extension, Docker, and remote containers. So let's get this started. So I'm going to start by opening Visual Studio Code, and I already have those three extensions installed, but if you don't, you can just look for them here on the extensions view in Visual Studio Code. So the Docker extension will give you support for managing containerized applications. The Python extension will give you support for Python development, including editing features such as IntelliSense, synchronous highlighting, linting, etc., as well as debugging and many other things. And the remote containers is the real star of the show today. This will allow Visual Studio Code to run as a server inside the container. So all your projects, dependencies, runtime, environment, everything is running in the container itself. And locally, you just have the UI. So you get the best of the local experience, but you're leveraging from this isolated and reproducible development environment. awesome. So let's get this started. Once you install the Docker extension, you're going to see this Docker icon here on the activity bar. And here I'm more interested in the containers, but it will give me a list of images and everything. And for example, if I start one of these containers, suppose you have a container running on your machine that you would like to attach Visual Studio Code to start your development, you can do so through the Docker extension and the remote container extension. So you can right click on the container you want and you can attach Visual Studio Code to it. This will open Visual Studio Code in this development environment and the container. Once you do this for the first time, it's going to take some time because it will build the container for you and everything. But you can see here that it opened the terminal and I'm actually in the container itself. So I have my folders, directories here, and I know that I am in a container because here on the left-hand side, it's telling me it. I can click here and see the features, some of the features that it allows me to do. So I can see the configuration file. I can open a folder or a workspace here in the container and everything like that. So that's really nice. But I am going to show how you can containerize an application using this extension in a very easy way. So I'm going to do that. First, I'm going to stop this and I'm going to open a folder. So I have here this simple Django application that I have here. We can see the views py, manage py and everything. Once I open the Python file, the Python extension will activate. But in this case, I want to create a configuration for the containers. So I'm gonna do that by first opening command palette. And I am going to look for the commands from the remote containers extension. Here, the one that I'm looking for is add development container configuration files. So once I click here, it will ask me, how would I like to create this configuration? Do I want to use an existing Docker file? Or do I want to use predefined container configuration definitions, which is what I'm going to use select for this example. And you can see here that there are many preset configurations that you can use. I'm going to look for Python. And even for Python, we have a few options. In this case, I'm going to just select this one. And we can see here that Visual Studio Code created this .dev container folder with two files. So one of them is Docker file, and this is going to be used to build my container. And we have the dev container JSON file. And this is actually going to be used by Visual Studio Code. So we have, for example, the path to the Docker file, adding a variant to update the Python version that you want to use. And it also copied all my settings from Visual Studio Code, my local environment, to be replicated in this dev container. So that's very nice. And here I can also update this list to tell Visual Studio Code to install extensions in the remote container as well. In this case, we have the Python extension, but if I want to, for example, add IntelliCode, I can come here to the extensions view and look for IntelliCode, which is an extension that provides AI-assisted development features, such as powerful autocomplete, for example, auto-completion features. And I can copy the ID of this extension that is right here, right next to its name, and add it here. Awesome. So this will make these two extensions be installed in the development environment. Let me enable it. So now that I have this all I have to do is to reopen this container in the container. So I can open the command palette again and click on reopening container, or I can also do it from this notification prompt that every time this folder is set, Visual Studio Code is going to ask us if we want to reopen this in the container. So that's really nice too. Awesome, so we can see here that I am in the dev container environment. I can reopen this folder locally if I want to, if I want to reboot it as well. And in this case, I forgot to uncomment a part of my Docker file that would install the requirements. But because I had already built this container before, I already installed the dependencies for this application. But if you're doing this on your own, you can just give this instruction so your dependencies will be installed when the container, after the container is built. Awesome. So I'm going to start by quickly running this application. So first, I am going to make sure I run migrations by opening the terminal and typing manage py migrate. That's fine. So I'm going to start debugging it here. I can see that I already have a list of configurations here under the run view on my debugger, but I can add a new one by clicking add configuration. I'm going to select Python. And here I'm going to select Django because this is a list of preset configurations that the Python extension offer for you. And I can see here that it's disabling the live reload feature from Django so that the server won't reload every change. I'm going to remove that because I want this functionality. And awesome. So I am going to select this new configuration and run it. And I have my application running, so I'm going to open it by control clicking it. Cool, so we have here this web page that I can just navigate here. And what's really nice about all of this is that it's actually, the debugger is running in the container. So if I, for example, want to see the platform this is running on, once I hit save, the web server is going to reload to apply these changes. So I'm going to come here. I'm going to add first a breakpoint. And once I come here, step over, I will see that the platform is Linux since it's the one that is in the container itself. So that's nice. So now that we've seen how to add configuration files for to start a dev container, I'm going to open an application that is already set up with these folders. It's a Django and React app, and it has our own Docker Compose file. So I'm going to open it by clicking File, Open Folder. And here it's going to show me the list of folders there in the container, but I can also ask to show the local one so I can open the one in my local machine. I'm going to select a folder. And what's really nice about all of this is that all the changes that I make while I'm in the remote container, they are applied locally because it's all done under a volume mount. So I don't lose any changes once I make them. And again, here I said that we have already this folder configured for remote containers extension. So here on the dev container JSON, I'm passing a Docker Compose file as well. And what I see here on Docker Compose, I can see that there are two services, one for the database and then one for the application itself. And our Docker file, it has a few commands to start up the container and install a few dependencies. I am going to uncomment this line so that my requirements are also installed once I am building this container. So I'm gonna reopen this in the container again. I can do it from here, or I can run the command from the command palette. And once you're doing this for the first time, it may take some time because it will be able to container, install the dependencies and everything there. So I'm going to speed this up in the video. Awesome. So it opened my application here. I can see that I am in the dev container environment here on the left hand side. And I already have some Python files open, so it's going to activate the Python extension. And I can see that it selected this environment for me. I can click here and select a different one if I want to, but this is the one that was used to install my dependency. So I'm gonna create a new terminal in VS Code. I'm gonna type Python dash dash version, and we can see that this is the one that is linked to. And once I do pip freeze, I can see that it installed my applications here for me in the container. Awesome. So I have here a test file that is for my application. So I can click here on the test view. It will show me a list of all the tests that I have on my application. I can run all of the tests at once, or I can also run individual ones. I can also debug tests and navigate to them through these icons. And we can see here that all is passing, so that's nice. So I am going to make sure there are no migrations to apply. And because this is a React, a Django application with React front end, I can start a script that we have here to start up the front end. Awesome. So I am going to run this application with the debugger. I can see that I already have a configuration here. If I want to edit, I can open the configuration file, and I'm gonna remove these arguments because I want to enable the live reload feature. So whenever I make changes, the web server will reload automatically. And I'm gonna run, let's see how it works. Awesome, so I open the application by control clicking on the link. And I can make changes, for example, under views.py. Ctrl-P just pulls up the list of files under my workspace, so it gives this quick open view in Visual Studio Code. And then here, I could, for example, set up a breakpoint once a tweet is going to be created. So I can say, hey there. And we can see that the breakpoint was hit. Once I step over, I can analyze the values. So we can see that user is anonymous is true. So this will return true, and then it will do perform an update to the value. And once I hover over again, it will show me that it changed the user to a different one. So if I hit continue, we can see that it logged in as Bob to tweet something there. So in this demo, we've seen how you can attach Visual Studio Code to a running container if you want to, or if how you can add dev container configuration files to an application you wish to containerize, and how you can open Visual Studio Code in this dev environment so that you have this isolated and replicable development environment. We've also seen how you can use the Python extension to have to debug Django applications in the container, and you have all the features that you would locally. So that was it. You can try all of these out today. You can get Visual Studio Code and extensions through the following links. Try it out, let us know how it goes, send us our feedback and your thoughts on how we can improve this experience for you. Thank you for watching. Bye.